So we continue our discussion of membrane-bound mediated responses that are caused by lipophobic ligands. Here, we are going to be focusing on enzyme-linked receptors. And so here's our image for an enzyme-linked receptor. The enzyme and the protein, or the enzyme and the receptor, are the same protein. So here we have your receptor in green, the enzyme here in purple, so the receptor and the enzyme are the same protein. Here you have a case where the ligand is not bound to the receptor. If it is not bound to the receptor, the enzyme is inactive. Here we're dealing with tyrosine kinase. Now, once the ligand binds to the receptor, then that is going to activate your enzyme. So step two, activate the enzyme. That happens again when the ligand binds to the receptor in step one. That activates the enzyme. Remember the name of the enzyme, tyrosine kinase. Kinases always phosphorylate. So here we are using ATP to phosphorylate a protein. And when you phosphorylate a protein, you get a response inside of the cell. From lab, you'll be discussing enzyme-linked receptors. This is the receptor for what hormone from your lab? Hopefully you answered insulin. Now, the response, if the ligand is insulin, so you have insulin binding, what response would you get in the cell? Well, if you recall from lab, that would be a GLUT transporter that gets inserted into the membrane. And when that GLUT transporter gets inserted into the membrane, now we can have absorption of glucose. So that concludes the video on enzyme-linked receptors.